Story tonight, News Channel 5 has learned a former South County minister accused of molesting children in his congregation may never go to trial.
We've been reporting on 83-year-old Reverend Thomas Jolly since last August. Now he's in a nursing home, too ill, his lawyers say, to stand trial. Deanne Lane has the latest on the night beat. Deanne?
Well, Karen and Rick, as we reported exclusively at 6 o'clock, Jolly's attorney plans to file a motion Friday claiming Jolly is not healthy enough mentally or physically to stand trial. That has his alleged victims and family members outraged, including the man you are about to meet who is concealing his identity.
It's impossible not to be furious at the attempts that they continue to make in trying to get him off the hook.
He has loss of memory. He can't tell us facts we need to know or dates we need to know. He doesn't even know who the vice president is. He thinks it's Walter Mondale.
Peter, as we'll call him, says his sister was fondled by Jolly during the late 80s when he led the Gospel Assembly Church in South County. He was ousted from there, but followers established another church in Metro East. Jolly faces 3 felony counts and 2 misdemeanor counts of fondling and sodomizing young girls. Jolly's attorney recently sent medical experts to examine Jolly and see if he has brain damage as a result of a stroke.
We're not claiming he's not guilty by reason of mental disease or defect. Our defense is that he didn't commit this crime that he's alleged to have committed to begin with. But in order to defend him, we've got to be able to have a person who's capable of going to trial and helping us to defend him.
It's my opinion that he's not insane at all. He's sitting over there and they're taking care of trying to make him look insane or totally incompetent. But as a matter of fact, just this past Sunday, he had sent a letter to a gathering of 1,500 people in a church in Louisville, Kentucky, and said he sends his greeting, and a pastor got up and read this.
And Jolly is reportedly in a nursing home over in Belleville. The prosecuting attorney has no comment until the motions are filed. As of now, Jolly's court date is set for June 1st. We should know more about this by the end of the week.
Okay, just a few days away. Thanks.